Today, we have the lovely Stacy Chalemi with us today of the Complete Herbal Guide. How are you, Stacy? Thanks for joining us.
I'm great. How are you?
I'm great. I'm great. Excited to hear about this company. So please just kind of tell us about maybe a snapshot journey of how you got to having the Complete Herbal Guide.
Okay. Well, you know, it started a long time ago. You know, basically at the age of 5, I developed epilepsy. I had encephalitis. It had traveled to my brain and it caused me to have epilepsy. I was in, you know, the hospital for a while. I was in a coma. And when I came out, you know, they thought I was going to be either paraplegic or I was going to have brain damage. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I came out and the first thing I asked for was McDonald's French fries. And, you know, it was a challenge, you know, growing up with this disorder and, you know, living life, you know, with a lot of challenges. It was definitely like a roller coaster ride. Mm. And when I got into college, you know, it was, you know, a lot of times stress can bring on seizures and, you know, my seizures were still weren't completely controlled at that moment. Okay. So, you know, during college, you know, the stress of studying, late night studying and all the other stuff that, you know, comes along with school, you know, it was really, really hard. And I started having a lot of seizures. So, what I did was I wrote an article and I sent it into the Epilepsy Foundation and they have a magazine. And I asked other people, well, how do you cope with this disorder? And I received hundreds of letters from all the United States and Canada from people just sharing their stories and sharing how they deal with it and how they cope with it. And it was really inspiring. And, you know, I kept a lot of those letters. And later on, I wrote a book called Epilepsy, You're Not Alone, because those letters really, you know, gave me inspiration and really gave me a lot of great advice. And I incorporated it into my own life. And it really helped me along my journey. And then I started to work in the city and I was working for a really big corporation. And one day I had a seizure and I fell to the ground and I ended up, you know, there was a producer and he like just walked over me and kept walking. And, you know, 30 minutes later, I was, you know, an associate came over and said, I'm sorry, but you don't fill this position. And, you know, I was released from my job, you know, because of that. So, you know, I was really distressed about it, but I wasn't going to let me get me down. Mm-hmm. And I ended up, you know, the Epilepsy Foundation asked me to go to Washington with them. I spoke in front of Congress and I did a lot of things to try to advocate for, you know, epilepsy and for the people who have this disorder. Mm-hmm. And along the way, I met a herbalist and this herbalist, I started doing a lot of writing and research for him. And it was really interesting. It was about how to heal your body naturally. This is what he was really into, is, you know, taking the things from outside, the alternative medicines and applying it to your body and healing your body. And I started doing a lot of this stuff while I was writing and researching. I was like, wow, you know, some of this stuff might actually help me. And, you know, I went from having like 9 seizures a month to 6 to 5 to 4 to 3 to 2. And my seizures, you know, became controlled and I was able to actually live, you know, a more normal, let's say, quote unquote, life where, so I applied a lot of that stuff and that stuff was so inspiring that I thought, you know, people besides me, besides people with epilepsy, if, you know, these things could really help them. So I started out a little blog. I'm Blogger. I don't know if you remember Blogger, but, you know, I started out, you know, doing a little blog and it went from 400 people and then it grew to 10,000. Then I created a website. I was working with this guy who designed websites. He's like, I can make you a really nice website with all this information you have. And I created a website and it grew to, you know, having, you know, hundreds of thousands of people come onto my website. So, and I, over the course of the years, I wrote books, I wrote over 20 books and that's how the brand started, you know, and I started helping people, doing a lot of speaking events, you know, teaching a lot of people from the materials in my book and, you know, constantly, you know, writing new and fresh content to help people learn how, you know, they can heal their bodies or how they can improve their life mentally and physically and spiritually through, you know, natural resources.
Wow. What a journey. So much that you do. And I'm just so appreciative that like you were able to go through that. And then of course, give back to others who go through similar things. And it's always things like that, where we don't realize that there's a lot of people going through similar situations and we kind of sometimes miss that community. So amazing that you created that community for yourself and for others. And so I'm curious, sort of all the elements that you, like you said, you cover, you've written books, you've done speaking, you've done all these things. What is your favorite aspect of it, would you say, in your business and what you do?
I think at this point of the game, I really enjoy speaking. You know, like mm-hmm. when I spoke in front of audiences, a lot of times people will come up to me and either they'll be in tears or they're hugging me and they're telling me that the things I say and the advice I give really, you know, really inspired them and really wanted to make them improve. And, you know, I think that's the biggest thing is when you do something in life, any type mm-hmm. of company or brand, when you do things and you improve somebody's life or you can, you know, help somebody, you know, it's a great achievement. I think one of the biggest achievements in life is being able to help others. You know, mm-hmm. I remember one time when I wrote my book, Epilepsy, You're Not Alone, that book, I had gotten a letter in the email and this woman said she was on the verge of committing suicide because she lost her job. She lost everything. She lost her driver's license. She couldn't do anything. And then she read my book and she started applying some of the things that I was teaching in my book and it changed her life. So, when I read that, it was just so inspiring. And it really made me realize that I was on the right path, that I was on the right journey. And I think speaking events and speaking to others is a great thing. You know, I just like helping people overall, but I really do enjoy getting in front of people and speaking to people and, you know, communicating with others in person.
Absolutely. And so how is it kind of explaining and working with these people, and you said speaking, realizing like a lot of these solutions, it sounds like, is really within us. It's just feeding the right things, like you said, spirituality, even foods and everything. How is it getting people to understand it's not all these fancy, you know, doctors and medicines and all these things? It can be a more natural way to do so.
You know, people, a lot of times in our society, we're so impatient. We always want change right away. You know, it's like we don't have the patience to change, but it takes time, mm-hmm. you know, and the first thing we have to realize is we have to, you know, go to the root of the problem or because there's always a reason why we're feeling the way we feel or, you know, and what we're going through in life mm-hmm. and figuring out what is the basis, what is the root causing these problems, and then figuring out a solution for it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it takes time, you know, and it's a day by day process, but, you know, little by little, you have to kind of realize first that you have to, you know, accept what's going on in yourself and realize and learn to love yourself, you know, and then you start figuring out what can I do, you know, to make changes in my life that will solve these problems and, you know, get me in life, you know, where I want to be.
And so what would you say is your favorite personal, you know, remedy and or maybe practice or habit to just kind of keep yourself, not just with the epilepsy, but just in general, keeping yourself spiritually sound and kind of in that high performance flow?
I love meditation and I love yoga and I've applied that to my life. And, you know, people don't realize, but you don't have to be so flexible to be able to do yoga. You know, people think of yoga and that they're thinking these
leg behind the head and everything.
Yeah. You know, I think if you could take 15 or 10 minutes out of your day when you wake up, do a little meditation and maybe do a little yoga, you know, sometime during the day where you have some, you know, free time, whether it's at night before you go to bed or in the morning, just like we spoke, you know, things like that could really help you, you know, it could help you mentally and it could help you physically and, you know, and creating a healthy lifestyle. And, you know, people don't realize, but a lot of times the foods we put in our body play a big, you know, are a big cause in how we feel, you know, and, you know, if you want to feel energetic, well, you know, you have to eat the right foods and you have to mm-hmm. do the right things. And a little mm-hmm. exercise, you know, is also helpful too.
Yeah, it's all flow. Like I said, it could just be a little bit. It doesn't have to be this big.
Yeah.
It can just be a little by little.
Just a little bit. Yeah. You don't need a lot, you know, but you know, just change and making little changes in your life could actually do a lot for you. You know, people don't realize that.
Absolutely. So you have your website, thecompleteherbalguide.com, and you also mm-hmm. have stacychalemi.com. So what are kind of the differences of those two and what can our listeners expect if they visit those websites?
Well, when you go into thecompleteherbalguide.com, that website, you know, has like over 5,000 articles on it, and it's mm-hmm. on every topic you can imagine, and it teaches you, you know, different ways to help yourself and to help your body and to help your mind and so forth. And stacychalemi.com is basically, it's a little bit more about me and about my journey and about, you know, what I can, you know, what I different guides and different things that I do that to help myself and my also my journey in life, and people kind of can follow me and follow what I'm doing. And if they have any questions, it's more, you know, a personal website where they can come in and they can, you know, ask me questions and ask me about, you know, things that they, you know, are curious about.
Mm-hmm. So it's been a whole journey, like you've mentioned, now the websites and everything. At least now your favorite part of this time of the game is speaking. Where do you see your business and just yourself going now in the next 3 to 5 years? What do you envision in the future?
Well, I, you know, like I said, my envision right now is I want to do more speaking events. You know, I have my books. I have over 20 books in the market. I have my websites, and I'm going to continue doing the websites, you know, and I have but I really would like to, you know, kind of work on different, you know, ways to help people in a more personal one-on-one or in a group way.
Okay, so if we have any listeners who need speakers and everything, let's kind of connect those opportunities here. What's the best way to get in contact with you to try and do so?
You know, people can find me on the StacyChillamy.com website. They can, you know, dot me out a question, or, you know, I even have, you know, it's a really easy email at StacyChillamy@StacyChillamy.com. So, you know, if they want to, you know, personally email me, they could email me there, and I'll be happy to, you know, speak with them.
Wonderful listeners, definitely go book that, ask questions. Thank you so much, Stacy Chillamy, for creating this community and sharing all of that with us today, and looking forward to hearing more speaking events from you. So thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome.